Good evening. I like to talk about the first verse in Yeshayahu 11, one of the most beautiful chapter in Yeshayahu that talk about the Dof Mashiach, the peace between all the animal, etc. It's one of the more beautiful chapters that talk about this age of when Mashiach will be here. The first verse in the chapter is Ve'yatza will come out from Ve'yatza Choter Migeza Yishai and Ve'netzer Meshorashav.
Can I translate in English?
Yeah. Choter, it's a tree when you cut it.
Log?
You cut completely all the tree in the how you call it? Bageza.
The trunk.
You cut all the tree, but it is a trunk. It is a piece of trunk up of the earth, but they are not branch. Mm-hmm. And then it came a little bit branch from this trunk.
Mm-hmm. New branch. New branches.
This is called Choter. Mm-hmm.
The new branches are Choter?
Yeah, the new branch that come from a tree that was completely cut off. It means, let's say that all the children of David was lost, but all of a sudden we reveal a new son of David, stay alive. So we call it a Choter. And Netzer, Mishorashav Yifreh. Netzer, it's not tree anymore, but only the Shorashim, how you call the Shorashim?
The roots.
Only the roots of the tree are there, and far from the place of the tree, it's not have to be in the same place, let's say, in another place, from the roots came a new tree mm-hmm. that is attaching somewhere to the original tree that don't exist anymore. It means the connection is under the ground. Mm-hmm. It's been in the subconscious. Subconsciousness. Uh-huh. Right? It's not a revealed connection, it's unrevealed connection. This is called Choter and this
The second one is a Netzer, right?
The second one is a Netzer.
The underground connection.
Underground, came from the root.
It's a Netzer.
The first one is a Choter and came from the trunk, a new branch. You cut all the
from the main trunk.
Yes.
Original trunk.
So we have here two words with the acronym of Chen. So this example of Chen, that Chen, it's mean a couple, always. Shnaim came to Noach, to the Ark of Noach. This represents the female. The female, it will be Chen. The male, it will be Noach. Right? Always. Noach is a point of wisdom, is a chokhmah, what we call the father. Nekudat, chokhmah, the acronym of point of wisdom, the yud of the name of Hashem. Chen is a female, in bima, in what we call the bina, the understanding, that to take the point and to make it large, it's a bina, to make a binyan, a building. To have banim, children, etc.
Bina is intelligence.
Yes, it's not exactly intelligent, but it's the mother that takes the point and extend the point to all building, all personality.
It's a sefirot from the.
It takes from the point, it takes from the seed, it makes a new baby, a new personality. It takes a point. The point is like the yud. The yud of the name of Hashem, what we call the father, it's a seed. And what he becomes a seed, in the mother, it's something very wide, right? It can be, it become all world. It become all a personality. So the father, we call it noir, start with nun, and the mother, we call it chen, it start with chet. Right? This is a couple, female and male. Who is a female? David. It's why we have there, came from Yishai. Right? Shai, the father of David. Here, how we know that we talk about Mashiach, son of Yosef? Notzer, it's like Notzri, what is Christian. Notzer, it means to keep, we talk about this many times, what it means Notzri. But Netzer, it's something like go from the root of the tree. And from this word, Netzer, what is like Notzri, what is like Christian, I can understand that we're talking about the other Mashiach, the Mashiach, son of Yosef. Now, here, with the acronym of Yimach. Yimach, what is equal Chen, Shmo. That Yimach, like we said, is the acronym of Yitzchak, Mashiach, Chen. Yimach. Right? Here we have it backwards, Yimach, the same acronym.
The other way around.
Yeah, but the same letter, what equal Chen. Now, here we have the acronym of Min. Min. Min is one of the names that our sages call in the Talmud, call the Christian. It's one of the names of the Christian is Minim. One is Min, but many is Minim. Has the acronym of the word Min, but it's another word for Notzri, for Christian. So we have here another hint about the fact that we are talking about Christianity. Now, Min, what is the acronym of Min? Yitzhak, Mashiach, and Noah. Min. Right? Min. Min. Here we have Yitzhak Mashiach Chen. Here we have Yitzhak Mashiach Noah. Here we talk about Noah, about the male Mashiach, the point, the yud of the name of Hashem. Here we talk about Mashiach ben David, the female Mashiach that have to do with Chen.
Female aspect.
Now, Min equal Yofi.
In Gematria,
100. Chen and Yofi are a couple, like Noach and Chen are a couple of male and female. Noach is a male and Chen is a female. The same way, it is a verse in Mishlei. Sheker Chen ve'evel Yofi. We talk about a couple, we have a lesson about this long time ago. The chen, the grace, is lie.
Associated with lie.
And the yofi, the beauty is associated with hevel.
What is hevel?
Hevel, it's like dust, it's like wind, it's like nothing, hevel. But like we explained, this is associated to true and this is associated to lie. Again, we have a couple of a male and a female. The emet is a male and the lie is a female. Both in holiness. Right? Now, if I do the gematria of these six words, Hoter, Megeza, Yishai, Netzer, Mishorasha, Mifre, the gematria of these six words equal exactly six times Mashiach. Six times 358. It means the average value of each one of these words is 358, what equal Mashiach. Mm-hmm. Right, so it's one of the more classics and basic verse about Mashiach that show me that Mashiach came in couple, like all the animals in the Ark of Noach. Shnaim, Shnaim, Ba'u El Noach El Ateva.
The two concepts together.
Shnaim, in order number, equal Chen, 58. Hmm. Alright? If I take the Chet and the Nun, and I multiply them, 8 times 50, equal 400, that equals Shnaim. So in another way, I see that Shnaim has to do with Chen. Chen always has to do with Shnaim. So, everything we talk about Mashiach...
Shnaim is two.
Shnaim, it means in Hebrew two. Shnaim, Shnaim came to the Ark of Noah.
In pairs.
In pairs, always two. So...
Couples.
If we talk about good, we must put there the evil as well. Both in holiness. If we talk about true, we must put the lie. Both together. Both in holiness.
So one cannot exist
with not the other one in the
unless body. There is the opposite. Because we can know about one only if we can compare with the opposite.
Yeah, but we need... I don't mean in the sense that with not the bad, I will not appreciate the good. This is not what I mean when I talk about bad in holiness. When I talk about bad in holiness, I talk that the bad is good. Not is good to make for just to know that I am not bad.
Bad is good as well.
Bad is good by himself. Alright?
Its origin.
He have origin of existence in holiness. Mm-hmm. So he must to be there. In a balance. If it's not in balance, so it's bad. It's bad the way we know the word bad. If it's in the right place, if you know his place, everybody has to know his place in all this world. In the moment everybody knows where his place, so we have a good world. Everybody do his function where he's supposed to do his function, in the right quantity. So then it's not wrong with what we call bad, or what we call Esav, or what we call lie, or what we call whatever.
We find harmony in the creation.
We must to have harmony, and we must to have all the concept in the creation of God, because this is the way the Torah is written, and the Torah is all holy. If the word is bad, it's because we gave a bad interpretation to the Torah. To our fault, if our fault are bad, we create an evil world. The creation of the world, Briat HaOlam, is to make the Olam, the world, Bari. Bari means healthy. To create, it means to make it healthy as well. So we have, exactly like God creates the world, we have to create the world. It means we have to make a better world, a healthy world.
To fix the world.
To fix the world, it means to create the world.
To correct the world. Yeah.
It's the same thing.
In a consciousness, in
the
in
last,
a con-
the
in a
last word
way.
In creation, the end of the day of Shabbat, is Asher Bara Elokim La'asot. God create to do, but to do in Hebrew La'asot, it means to fix. God creates the world to fix.
but in a conscient way.
It means the Shabbat is not finished yet. It means the creation is not finished. It is not written Vayi Erev, Vayi Boker, Yom Shabbat. It is not written morning, it was evening, it was morning, Yom Shabbat. It's like the creation is not finished in the Torah, right? So we have to accomplish the creation of God.
Finalize.
Not like the Islam, which says that everything is God, is no cause, is no reason for anything. We have to fix the world. We have to invite things. We have to learn. We have to make the world better.
So we have a responsibility.
We have a responsibility, like God give us part of Himself. He give us part of Himself to accomplish His work.
Finalize.
To that the world it will be a place for revealing of God here. From the earth, God give Himself to us from the ground, from the earth. Emet me'er titzmar. Right, so all the truth grew from the earth, from the nature. Right, thank you.